is, thank you guys for all the support and for watching my videos. If you want to get the most out of my channel, here are a few quick tips for you to be able to get the most and learn as quickly as possible. So first up, we have our Mike's Brush name here. You could click on this and it takes you directly to my channel. You'll have access to all my videos. You'll have a backlog of, you know, over 100 videos that you could go through, watch, and learn that way. There's a very helpful how to airbrush series in there that I would recommend. A lot of people ask what stuff I use. Clicking on that description button will open up this that shows the links to a lot of the most commonly asked questions. Using these links helps the channel bring you more videos, better quality videos. As always, I would recommend you stay subscribed to keep up to date on the latest videos. And if you really, really enjoy the videos, you can consider joining so you get these cool emojis in the chat, as well as access to some other features. Clicking that join button will explain everything for you. And yeah, like I said, you can click here, it takes you over to my channel. You could see a backlog of all our videos. Click on this videos tab. It shows you all, you know, everything, all the videos from the past. I highly recommend it. Like I said, there's a how to airbrush series up in there. And in the community tab is how I keep track or keep in touch with most of the members, let everybody know what's kind of happening, what's going to go on. And yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. We could get back to the video. Good luck to y'all. All right, what's up, everybody? How's everybody doing? Today we have a big painting. Look at the size of this thing. And we're going to be doing prints. And I realized today was leap year. So the name of the stream is Prince Leap Year Live Stream, so that I could remember later on that this was made during leap year. But I hope everybody's doing good. Hope everybody's having a good Saturday. And I'm going to be doing purple today. So we have fluorescent violet here that I'm going to start off by working the base with this. I'm going to do like half paint and half reducer. The fluorescent colors are pretty thin, so that's the 4012 reducer. You guys should be pretty familiar with that by now. So, I think I'm just going to start, I don't know, I'm going to start here on this cheek and start building tones off of that, that way I can kind of get a good idea where we're going with it. I still got the sniffles from being sick too. And I might blow my nose a couple times during the stream, so just know that ahead of time. In case you hear that. I also decided to go with no music today because I looked back on the previous streams with the music and it makes it just harder to understand what I'm saying. So, give the space better. If you guys have questions or anything in the chat, I am watching the chat. So, what's up, Laval Scott? Thank you, sir. What's up, Anthony Villaseñor? What does the 4012 done? It's a reducer, so it makes the paint thinner, easier to spray, makes it flow better. It makes it so that I could do like this really nice shading and stuff. How Matos? Hi. Watch out. Thank you, Anthony. Thank you, sir. Yeah, I'm still a little sick, man. Not gonna lie. And this is just transparent purple. It's a really dark color. I'm going to reduce this one about 3 to 1. 3 parts reducer, 1 part paint. I'm mixing up enough in here to really cover the whole painting, but I'm going to do some details and go back and forth. What's up, Rick? How's it going? Thank you, man. Thank you. I didn't dilute the color. I reduced the color, and we used 4012 reducer around here.
Around here. This is the one we use.
What's up, Easy Airbrush? Good morning, sir. I already showed, I said 3-to-1 paint, 3-to-1, 3 parts reducer, 1 part paint. You kind of gotta be here for the whole shebang. How much do I think I can get paid so that you can go charge that? That's funny, bro. I usually do the canvases 16 by 20 for around $50 if it's a cartoon character, which animes are. Sure, you charge for the canvas too. Like, I wouldn't upcharge the canvas or nothing like that. Like, if it costs you $20, make sure you tell them it's gonna be $50 to spray it, and it costs $20 for the canvas. So keep that in mind as well. Prince is a very unique person to paint because he has a particular look. All right, Rick, have a good day at work, man. I hope you have a good day at work. Yo, what's up, Air Todd? How's it going, man? Air Todd Bemis, I like it. I like it, bro. La verdad que son las mismas líneas que los demás. Nada más este dibujo está mucho más grande. O sea, normalmente yo estoy haciendo dibujos así del tamaño de una mano. O sea, esta nariz es. La nariz nomás es del tamaño de mi mano. Nomás es más grande, se miran más finas, pero la verdad que son iguales. La única razón que estoy usando estos aerógrafos es porque tienen su propio vaso, se so puedo mezclar y reducir la pintura aquí adentro de este vaso y sin tener que ensuciar uno de mis botellitas. Que reducir adentro de las botellas no es recomendado porque al reducidor empieza la endurecedor, empieza el endurecedor de las pinturas, pues. So las pinturas empiezan a ser gomosas y feas, pues, después de que las reduzcas. La verdad es que después de 24 horas empiezan a ser medio gomosas. Nomás es recomendado reducir afuera los vasos estos, no en las botellas. That's pretty good looking. So let's move on. Estoy usando diferentes tipos de aerógrafos. Thank you. Right on. Thanks, Shane. Oh my god, that looks really good. Sometimes I impress myself. Sometimes. But I need to take a quick restroom break. So while we're taking this restroom break, how about a word from the channel? Yeah, I'm just gonna grab myself something to drink and go to the restroom real quick. I'm trying to figure out. I need to order another one of those airbrush holders so I can have another separate one over here for when I'm painting. But yeah, enjoy this quick commercial break. I'll be right back, guys. Yo, what's up, guys? Thank you guys for all the support and for watching my videos. If you want to get the most out of my channel, here are a few quick tips for you to be able to get the most and learn as quickly as possible. So first up, we have our Mike's Brush name here. You could click on this and it takes you directly to my channel. You'll have access to all my videos. You'll have a backlog of, you know, over 100 videos that you could go through, watch, and learn that way. There's a very helpful how to airbrush series in there that I would recommend. A lot of people ask what stuff I use. Clicking on that description button will open up this that shows the links to a lot of the most commonly asked questions. Using these links helps the channel bring you more videos, better quality videos. As always, I would recommend you stay subscribed to keep up to date on the latest videos. And if you really, really enjoy the videos, you can consider joining so you get these cool emojis in the chat, as well as access to some other features. Clicking that join button will explain everything for you. And yeah, like I said, you can click here. It takes you over to my channel. You can see a backlog of all our videos. Click on this videos tab. It shows you all, you know, everything, all the videos from the past. I highly recommend it. Like I said, there's a How to Airbrush series up in there. And in the community tab is how I keep track we're keeping in touch with most of the members, let everybody know what's kind of happening, what's going to go on. And yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. We could get back to the video. Good luck to y'all. All right. What's up, Air Todd? You know two Todds. I like it. The alter ego, man. The alter ego. Air Todd is like your superhero. I'm pretty sure in this picture they photoshopped his forehead into a smooth, flat surface. Because that's what it looks like in the picture. It's just like his nose too. It's so smooth that I don't believe it's real. Especially when you add, they left all the detail of his skin on his cheeks, right? But then you look at his, like, this areas and his nose and this up here. It's really smooth, and it's just like, I don't know if he was that smooth. Hell yeah, Todd. That skull is sick, man. Those skulls are gonna be so sick. So. But there we go. There we got. I think we're pretty good on the face for now. And I think I'm just gonna start working on this hand down here. Is on this side, so again, just starting off with the fluorescent violet. That's a dope Michael Jackson. Oh shit. Oh my gosh, I missed. Sorry. You haven't joined the squad. You should. You can have a cool squad. Yeah. I don't know if you missed that video, but that video says all that. So yeah. Thank you, Todd, though. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. Sorry, I was. zoning out over here. Thanks, man. Thank you for understanding. My phone has gone off a few times too, and I haven't even checked it, so. No, and this is not a commission. This is just, I didn't know what to stream today. We need to stream today. We're going to be moving the whole studio around, so I needed to get one last stream in here for today for YouTube algorithm purposes in order to keep us on top. And yeah, so I asked my wife what she wanted. And she said, I want a picture of Prince. And so me, I have to oblige. There I am, painting a nice, really nice picture of Prince. I went out and got some really extra large canvases. So I figured, like, if we're going to have a picture of Prince in the house, it better be a pretty good one. And I'm going to try to do the time lapse and use the Purple Rain song, and hopefully, you know, it's gonna get flagged for demonetization, or, you know, they're gonna want to claim it. It's fine, so I'm just gonna have to not get paid for that one. It's just okay, so not every video has to make money. Yeah. Camera's doing a pretty good job today, but It's just not as clear on the camera. You can't really see like all the. You can kind of see it, but you can't really see it too well. There's all that detail in there. That'll probably be the next thing I get. The next big purchase for the channel will be a camera, and not just like a webcam, because that's what we're working off of, right? No, I'm not getting booted to the garage. We're actually moving to a different room with more space, because now that I have the table and everything, it's gonna need more space, and going forward with the videos and stuff. So yeah. The garage is already full of stuff. And there's an undisclosed project already in there that I can't really talk about. And you guys will be seeing more of in the coming months. I'm just getting that all worked out. And yeah, I said in the coming months. Like once it gets done, we still have to go through the videos, edit the videos up, and then we have to wait for the reveal before we could post the videos. So, different kind of project. I'm gonna switch over to this hand over here. I think that's pretty good right there. Trying to paint at 45 PSI was hard. What do you mean? How fast do you move the brush? I mean, I don't know, man. Yes and no, because I understand what that statement is trying to say, but at the same time, you should probably get good at a constant pressure. So, in the past, not even that distant past, but in the past, I've painted at different PSIs. So, like, I was depending on what I was doing, I would change. And what happens is you start becoming inconsistent with certain stuff, like finer stuff. You start trying to find ways of using higher pressure in situations when you clearly know you should be using lower pressure. At least that's what I was trying to do, and it honestly ends up hurting you more than it does providing you any kind of benefit. Like I've explained before too, you gotta really think about it at the surface level. Right, so a good way to like is like just look at your arm, right? When you do this on your hand and you get that little pit in there. All right. Just imagine what the air is doing when it hits a flat surface like this. And like it's possible to paint, at like 70 or 100 PSI, like easy airbrush. I mean, you can. It's technically possible. But you're also wasting a lot of paint, because a lot of paint's gonna just be flying everywhere because you're creating so much turbulence at the surface that the paint is gonna fly off in different directions. Like it's the not, just because it's spraying really hard onto the surface doesn't mean the paint is actually making it there, because if you're spraying so hard that the surface is, pushing air back, you could end up in a situation where you'll be spraying, you won't even notice. But then if you look like me, I'm painting in a room. If I was painting at 70 PSI, after a while I'd be able to look around and see that I'm in a big ass cloud of paint. Not only that, the paint in the airbrush itself would be going through a lot faster. But like I said, it is possible, and there are situations where it's necessary. Like if you're painting on a wall, you know, and even a slight breeze really messed things up, so you want to maybe increase the pressure a little bit so that you can make sure the paint makes it onto the surface. But again, you're battling turbulence, right? Because that's all the wind is. So it's a give and take. See, so I have this one hooked up here. These are all hooked up to the same manifold. It's 45 PSI across the board. But yeah, generally, I like running those. If I'm like painting a shirt or something, I'll run those a little bit higher. Maybe 50 PSI, maybe 55. I don't like going any higher than that. Again, it's possible, and if that's what you like to do, I'm not going to stop you. There's no correct way to just airbrush, you know. So you do what you're comfortable with. That's what I would say. But in general, that is what you're doing. Is you're going to end up wasting a lot of material, and you're going to make your compressor run harder. You know, there's a whole bunch of drawbacks. If you're painting on shirts and you're painting at high PSIs, you'll notice that your boards will be extra soaked. You know, with paint, you'll notice it'll be harder to lay highlights over some of the other colors, you know, like with white and stuff, because the paint is just blowing through the fabric, like it'll just, you know, so. And like on a, like this, a surface like this, you paint at 70 PSI, it's going to make it hard to get fine lines. You'll have to work extra hard at it. And I don't, right now I think I'm like at, actually like 40 PSI, I'm not even like at 45, pretty low today. But like you guys, well, I don't know if you were here when I put the reducer, but I put a lot of reducer in here today, so this paint is just like, you know, almost water. Yeah, 25 to 30 PSI for shirts is probably too low. Yeah, 45 PSI for shirts is probably 45 to 55 PSI is what I would recommend for shirts. Like I was just saying, is you'll end up blowing paint through the fabric. So it's just something to watch out for if you're, if that's something you're doing. Especially on shirts where you could end up using a lot of paint if you're not careful. You know, some shirts require a lot of stuff. And if you're just already wasting paint and then you have to lay, you know, 10 colors or something because they wanted rainbow lettering or something, you know, then you could end up using so much paint just to try to get that rainbow effect to look right. And yeah, I remember using about 60 PSI to 70 PSI when I was painting at the markets and we were super busy. I would turn up the pressure just to be able to work faster. But again, it was that trade-off where it was just like, I was just painting so fast. You know, we weren't trying to make every shirt look amazing. You know, we were just painting, you know. At that point, people just want their shirt. So it's like, that's what we were doing. We were just trying to pump out as many shirts as I could. So And I mean, if I go out to the market this year and it turns out it's really busy, I'll, maybe make some videos on how to work with faster or higher pressure. But I mean, you already got to be experienced. You got to know how to airbrush pretty darn good already to be able to turn that pressure up. Because you're going to have to move fast. Your airbrush is going to have to be running pretty much perfectly to be able to match the response speed that you're going to need to keep moving that trigger back and forth and moving and going fast. What the streets created, what's up? Yeah, you when you're spraying shirts, you do want to get it through and through. You don't want to just blow it through the fabric, and you don't want it to just sit on the top layer either. You kind of want it not to soak, but you want it to cover most of the, as much as the fabric. And when you press, that's really what's gonna make sure that your airbrushing kind of lasts. So just like when you're working with a pencil, it's better to create the stroke, what I would call with confidence, as opposed to being hesitant and getting a shaky outcome. So you don't have to go fast, but it definitely helps make everything smoother. Because the slower you go, the more shaky it's going to be. And when you move fast, one singular motion, it just works out better. And don't be afraid to ask questions, like that's what the chat is for. So I'm pretty sure you're answering questions that probably other people that are going to watch now or later are going to be like, oh wow, that's what I'm doing wrong. And that's the only way to get better is to ask questions. And you're asking real questions, not like, what kind of paint you use? Yeah. Cool. So I think that looks pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and do the dark. Yeah, man, that's good. I don't know why, but I never had that weird. Well, what I consider weird, it's probably just normal. I'm probably the weird one, but I never had that nervousness. I was just kind of just. I don't know. I picked it up and I was determined. I was like, this is gonna be my tool. I never knew it would go this far, but. Just from watching it when I first seen it and looking at pictures and stuff, and I knew that it was something I wanted to learn. I don't know why, it just called to me. All right, we'll see you, Eric Todd, man. Thank you for hanging out. I like it, Todd. I like it. This guy's funny. Have a good day at work, man. Thanks for the laughs, Todd. So, Naomi, if you want to check out that join button below, I don't usually answer people's emails if it's just about wanting to airbrush. The best I could do is to tell you to watch my videos and to practice. And good luck. But one of the options is to join the channel and become part of the Skull Squad. Like Air Todd there in the chat and get that cool skull. You can click that join button and it'll explain the rest. And one of the tiers includes me. Like one-on-one chat. Helping you out with your airbrush troubles. And that falls right in that category. Down. Now that we have all that done, I'm just going to go ahead and worry about his suit and stuff down here. There you go. Epic boy. Bet I like it. Maybe this mail. I can't understand what you're trying to say, bro. I don't understand the sentence. I'm trying to read it, but I don't understand. I want to understand. The spells. My bad, bro. I can't do nothing about the spell check. Yeah, it can be for sale. It's just my wife's off-the-cuff pick. I believe I said it earlier that we were just looking for something to paint. And we had no idea. And then my wife is like, I really want a picture of Prince. Sure, she'll be sad, but then she'll be happy. So there's a really easy way to locate me. If you just Google Mike's Brush or Mike's Brush Airbrush, it should take you to our website, or the website is www.mikesbrush.com. You'll find all my information there. And this is a 24 by 30 canvas. And with the amount of time that we're going to be putting into it, I would say I would let it go for about $500, more or less. We're 2 hours in. I would say it's probably going to be another hour. So, and then I might do a little bit, in a day or two, once I'm sitting and looking at it and stuff, I might do a little touch-ups here and there. But for the most part, that'll be it. reached the part of his neck which is really dark, so I'm just going to go ahead and just lay down some of this fluorescent purple here. As a base. New York with a purple moon. Yeah, I guess that would look nice. I was just kind of thinking of keeping it plain and or adding some purple rain to it, like raindrops, and maybe make it look like some of them are like, you know, running down his hands here. It's kind of what I was thinking. But I don't know. Thank you. Let's see here. Yeah, I tried that pit bull, but it doesn't actually turn out so well. It makes it harder to hear my voice, and also the sound of the airbrushing messes with the sound of the music. I don't know if it has something to do with the way YouTube processes audio or what, but it makes everything just sound kind of funky. If you go back through my previous streams, you'll see some of them have music, and then I just decided it'd be better to take it off. Try and answer people's questions when they come in here. Makes it harder. Right on, thank you, Kayo style. Thank you, sir. Yeah, hopefully somebody finds some value in it, you know. All right, now we can focus on this. Or wait, actually, we need to do this part and believe. Yeah, there's just a piece right here. Alright, now his neck. And I'm getting tired. I need to get some more water and take a quick restroom break again. And you guys can enjoy a quick little commercial break and enjoy learning how to watch the channel, how to get a good. Yo, what's up, guys? Thank you guys for all the support and for watching my videos. If you want to get the most out of my channel, here are a few quick tips for you to be able to get the most and learn as quickly as possible. So first up, we have our Mike's Brush name here. You could click on this and it takes you directly to my channel. You'll have access to all my videos. You'll have a backlog of, you know, over 100 videos that you could go through, watch, and learn that way. There's a very helpful how to airbrush series in there that I would recommend. A lot of people ask what stuff I use. Clicking on that description button will open up this that shows the links to a lot of the most commonly asked questions. Using these links helps the channel bring you more videos, better quality videos. As always, I would recommend you stay subscribed to keep up to date on the latest videos. And if you really, really enjoy the videos, you can consider joining so you get these cool emojis in the chat, as well as access to some other features. Clicking that join button will explain everything for you. And yeah, like I said, you can click here. It takes you over to my channel. You could see a backlog of all our videos. Click on this videos tab. It shows you all, you know, everything, all the videos from the past. I highly recommend it. Like I said, there's a how to airbrush series up in there. And in the community tab is how I keep track or keep in touch with most of the members, let everybody know what's kind of happening, what's going to go on. And yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. We could get back to the video. Good luck to y'all. Alright, guys, just give me 1 second to get a drink of water and stuff real quick. So we're all good to go now. And yeah, now we gotta focus on his chest down here. I'm gonna lower my chair all the way down. Feeling off kind of sick and feeling not so bad now. I hope everybody's feeling good. Nobody's getting sick. Thank you. It's funny how much that changes it. Not even done yet, and already looks so much better. It looked weird with the white neck. Violet, that purple really gets really dark if you just keep layering it on, so here's a interesting tidbit, right? So we're talking about how air pressure and the speed. So I haven't changed the air pressure, but I'm changing the speed. And if you notice, the slower I go, I'm able to get a darker line. Roxanne, she think I'm a player. That in there. That's more dark. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Leave that alone. So, last but not least, I think we got all of that. That looks good. Would be the hair. See, look at that. That looks really good. But we need to get this hair done. All right, so let me lower this canvas for one. It's way too high. I can't reach. Make it easy. Make it easy. All right. That's better. Cool. And we could just start right here with all this little baby house. And I actually think this is reduced too far, so I'm just gonna go ahead and add a little bit more purple to this. Maybe take some of that out, just a little bit. And then I'm gonna add purple. It's a little bit too transparent, and I just want these thick lines to be nice and dark right away, so for the hair. I just realized I didn't move the camera. I moved the canvas, didn't move the camera. Oh, perfection. There you go. I don't know your last name. Koraji? Dano Koraji. What's up, man? How's it going? Thank you. So I'm gonna switch off to my badger here and to the unreduced purple. That way we can just fill that in nice and quick. I won't be pretty much done after that. Dang, that looks pretty good. I don't think it needs anything else. So let me just flip it over this way. And get you guys out here. It's so big, I can't even get the whole thing. But anyway, guys, I hope you guys liked the stream. That was only, what, how long? 3 hours? And I'm undecided if I want to add a background or not, but I think it looks pretty good just like that. Maybe just accent some of these right here. Go. There you go, guys. Hopefully you guys liked that video. And I don't know what else to say besides thank you for watching. So hard to get the camera just right. There you go. Yeah, I hope you guys like it. There you go, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Yo, what's up, guys? Thank you guys for all the support and for watching my videos. If you want to get the most out of my channel, here are a few quick tips for you to be able to get the most and learn as quickly as possible. So first up, we have our Mike's Brush name here. You could click on this and it takes you directly to my channel. You'll have access to all my videos. You'll have a backlog of, you know, over 100 videos that you could go through, watch, and learn that way. There's a very helpful how to airbrush series in there that I would recommend. A lot of people ask what stuff I use. Clicking on that description button will open up this that shows the links to a lot of the most commonly asked questions. Using these links helps the channel bring you more videos, better quality videos. As always, I would recommend you stay subscribed to keep up to date on the latest videos. And if you really, really enjoy the videos, you can consider joining so you get these cool emojis in the chat, as well as access to some other features. Clicking that join button will explain everything for you. And yeah, like I said, you can click here. It takes you over to my channel. You could see a backlog of all our videos. Click on this videos tab. It shows you all, you know, everything, all the videos from the past. I highly recommend it. Like I said, there's a how to airbrush series up in there. And in the community tab is how I keep track or keep in touch with most of the members, let everybody know what's kind of happening, what's going to go on. And yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. We could get back to the video. Good luck to y'all.